Yeah, hi everyone. So we had a little excursion last time talking about linear algebra. Today there will be another little excursion talking about some concepts in calculus because they will be useful for fitting neurons with gradient descent. So today the lecture will be on gradient descent, and I will have some optional sections on some calculus topics as a little refresher. But yeah, because I think there's a lot of stuff to cover today, I will keep the introduction short and just dive in. Yeah, so the goal here in this lecture is to improve upon the perceptron that we covered last week. So in this lecture, we are going to talk about or learn about a neural network model for which the training always converges. So even if the data is not linearly separable. Here's an overview of the big picture goals. So our goals overall. So like I just said, in this lecture, we are focusing on a learning rule that is more robust than the perceptron, so that it always converges even if the data is not linearly separable. But yeah, that is not the end goal of this course. Of course, we want to learn about more sophisticated models compared to single layer neural networks. So what we really care about is also how we can make or create more complex classifiers that can solve more complicated problems than just binary or linearly separable problems. Because if I have something like that, where I have two classes, I mean, this is relatively trivial, right? So the perceptron again had the shortcoming: if a data point is over there, there is no linear decision boundary such that there is no mistake, so in that way it would never converge. But even, let's say, if we have a learning rule that converges like this, this is a relatively trivial problem, and in practice we are interested in more complicated problems. So we need to also find a way to combine multiple neurons, because these combinations of multiple neurons or deep neural networks can help us to learn such more complicated decision boundaries. And then with that, we can solve also complicated real world problems. There are many like object detection and, let's say, classifying arbitrary things. So in that way, that is something we will then start tackling in the next lecture. So first, here we lay the groundwork talking about the learning rule, and then we will apply the same learning rule to the combination of neurons. And also we will then learn how we can extend this to multiple categories. It will also be next lecture or next week. So we will learn also how we can classify problems where we have more than two classes, which is also important, of course, right? If you think about, let's say you build an application for a bird watcher to classify birds outside, so there are more than just two bird species, right? So in that way, we'll also learn about methods that can handle multiple classes. And then, more towards the end of the course, we will then also learn how to do fancier things, not just classification, but also like things like generating new images and new text and things like that. But all these types of things are based on the same learning algorithm and extensions of this learning algorithm. It's not like fundamentally different though. And in this lecture here, we will learn the core principle of this learning algorithm that we will be using for the rest of the semester. So, and also the good news is, after this lecture here, there won't be any new mathematical concepts. So in this lecture, I will talk a little bit about calculus, but that is about it when it comes to the mathematics of this course. Of course, there will be mathematical concepts or applications of the concepts we discussed, like the linear algebra stuff and calculus stuff in this lecture, but there won't be any new fancier concepts. So after this lecture, you can relax, there won't be any new mathematical complicated things going on. So everything also in deep learning will be extensions and applications of these basic concepts in linear algebra and calculus that we are covering now. So just to give you the big picture overview of things I have in mind for this lecture. So first we are going to talk about the different learning modes. There's something called online, batch, and mini-batch learning. It is a general concept that applies to all types of single layer neural networks and multi-layer neural networks, convolutional networks, and everything basically in deep learning. And after just this big overview here, we will talk about the relationship between the perceptron and linear regression. And then we will learn about an iterative training algorithm for linear regression. You probably know the closed form solution for linear regression. Matrix formulations, such a short dense formula for solving for the weights and the bias unit directly. Here we will talk about an iterative learning algorithm because it helps us understand how we can train our neural networks. It's kind of very closely related. I will have a little calculus refresher. This will be optional, so you notice that there are 7 sections this time. It may be a little bit long, so this is also really just optional. It's I thought it might be good for some of those who have taken calculus a long time ago, or maybe are not quite sure about calculus anymore. So in that way, it's like a little refresher, but if you are very familiar with calculus, you don't have to watch these videos. So in that way, it will be a shorter lecture. It's also something, these optional things, that I probably wouldn't have covered in the in-person class because, yeah, this is more like a prerequisite. So in this way, I wouldn't want to make the lecture in person too long. But if you like, you can watch them, but you're not required to. So it's just some background information, optional stuff. And after that, we will be talking then about gradient descent, that is the learning algorithm that I briefly outlined in the previous video. And then we will be training a linear neuron, Adeline. And I will also show you then a code example in PyTorch of how we can train such a linear neuron using the concept of gradient descent. All right, so then let's get started with the first video on online batch and mini batch mode in the next video.